let's say we all know there is a lot of calculators available, like Black-Scholes model. People say about delta, theta, gamma. But I'm going to give you a simple technique, which is needed for any professional trader to quickly understand what will be the premium provided if the price goes up or down. So I'll just give you a shortcut for you to understand. But this particular session needs a reasonable understanding of call options and put options and how a buyer seller makes money. Let's quickly understand this. Let's say I'll just given you a few call options. Look at this. There is 11,900 call option trading at 89, 11,950 call option trading at 64, 12,000 call option trading at 44, and 12,050 call option trading at 29. And if you look at what is the current market price of that underlying, which is around 11,800. It means when you see there is 11,800, this 11,900 strikes is trading at the rate of 89. It means, yes, because we got a 10 days to go, which is quite easy for a market to climb even above 11,900. That is the reason why 11,900 carries 89 as a premium. I hope now you understood. When compared to 11,950, eventually 12,000 carries a lesser premium. When compared to 12,000, 12,050 carries a lesser premium, because chances for 11,800 call option to go beyond 12,050 is actually less likely. Am I right? So this is high likely when compared to less likely. That is the reason why the premium is high. Murugan, how do we calculate the premium, Murugan? Let's say by tomorrow, if a market goes to 11,850, if a market increases by 50 rupees, what should be the premium, Murugan? I may probably guess this. Look at this one. Since it is 100 rupees away from the current market price, people are willing to pay 89 rupees. I'm just going by a shortcut. Since it is 100 rupees away from here, people are willing to pay 89 rupees. By any chance, tomorrow, if this price becomes 11,850, let's say if the market increases towards 11,850, even this strike price is just away by 100 rupees. So eventually what happens? This will also becomes closer to 89, provided if it happens instantly. But if it happens by tomorrow, although it has only 100 rupees, it got only 9 days to go. So what happens? The premium may not be exactly 89. This 64 will actually become how much? Close to 89, but not exactly 89. So if there is a lot of time gap, in one day it is not a big deal. But if we have only 5 days or 4 days, then eventually you don't expect the same premium. Still the premium tends to be low. So what am I trying to say? Look, I managed to guess the premium of 11,950 of tomorrow's premium when I'm expecting price goes to 11,850. How? Because when there is a 100 rupees difference, 89, there is 150 rupees difference, it is 64. By tomorrow, if this happens to be 11,850, this may be closer to 64 rupees. This 44 can even become 64. So when you understand this, the next level of understanding becomes delta. What is it? That is what a lot of people tends to complicate. Delta is very simple. When you see there is a change in price in underlying and how much change is actually happening with respect to the option price. So whenever you see the call option, price tends to go up when you see the underlying price moving up, provided there is a reasonable time gap. So that is the reason why everything got a different delta. How? Look at this. This particular contract, 64 becomes 89. It means this can actually gain 15 rupees when a market gains by 50 rupees. When a market becomes 11,850, this probably become 89. If you want to know how this becomes 89, I've already explained it. It's better you rewind it and understand it. So what we understand that this 64 can become 89, provided a market increases by how much? 50 rupees. So what happens to this guy? When a market increases by 50 rupees, this actually becomes 64. So 64 become 44, you see about 20 rupees differences when you see the price increases by 50 rupees. So I think this is something which can help us to understand there is a change in price with respect to it. I'm not giving you the exact calculations. I've just taken a rough numbers, but try to understand. It's quite simple to figure out the premium of so-and-so strike price with respect to change in underlying by looking at other strike price of the current market price. So this is one way of understanding the the term called delta. Likewise, there are a lot of interesting hacks are available. So, but these things are not necessarily needed to complicate it. So there are a lot of simple calculators available. Just feed in your data to get it. Just because a lot of people really want to have an understanding, we just made this for you people. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching it.